So, this time I have my rulers, my Fimo things, my drawing board clips, and some canvases. And these clips definitely keep, not bring joy, but they're really useful when I need to like clip my paper down. And here are some of my rulers. And these also, like, are from tools group, so my French curves, ellipse guides that I have so many because, well, there are many kinds of ellipses, like different sizes and different degrees. And these are really handy if you use like the, what is called, Scott Robertson How to Draw Book here. There he talks a lot about ellipses. So I have these ellipse guides here. I'll definitely keep all of these. And then I have some rulers. And my like Cyaneink ruler or geo ruler. I'm not sure what is English, but triangle ruler. And some rulers, regular ones. I think I will definitely keep this checker one because it starts like you can see because this clear one. But because it starts right here, so it's easily like measure things. There's like any gap there. And this metal one, of course. And this small yellow one because it fits in my pencil case. And this is Turner ruler that I got from with Turner Quashet. And I think this can go because I don't need that many rulers. Then my fixative, which I really hate, it's really crappy and it doesn't fix anything and definitely not bring me joy, definitely bring more like pain. But I don't have anything to replace this because this is like health, it should be like safe to use, like health safe, it's like it says. It doesn't smell that bad and I can use this because I can't use aerosols, I have asthma and it's really, I just have to keep that, using that, so I have like no choices. And some tools that I use with my Fimo. Actually this one has like ball-ended tool, an extra knife, which is really dull now, so I really want to buy a new one. And this is the knife that I use for cutting. It's really dull also. More those Kinder Surprise eggs. I have one of my polymer clay sculptor inside of this. Because this can like handle the polymer clay quite well. Oh, there's trash inside. Let's take the trash out. So I will keep two of these because I think I have some. And here is Fimo liquid clay. It's actually really useful. I'm not sure. Actually, I find every time I use Fimo, I definitely feel some joy because it's so relaxing because I don't film it. I'm so beginner with those that I don't have like any pressure. So here are my Fimos. I'm not going through this because I definitely will use all of these. They're all keep. And then I have some canvases. These are all my unused canvases. They are white in different sizes. Some of them are like board, some of them are like proper red stretched ones. Oh, these ones are like foam core. I think I would use this as painting surface sometimes. More stretches canvases. Some of these I have against, so some of these are in the packaging. I buy my canvases almost like a bulk when they are on sale, so that's why I have so many of these. And I'm not throwing these away because I really, well, I sometimes use all colors on acrylic and then I need canvases, so it's nice to have like stash of canvases to use then. Just every time, just have to like run into store to buy them. Because they are actually quite expensive in the normal process. They are much easier to get in, like, in the, well, in the Russian sale. And there are half finished slash finished paintings that I have. And these are old ones. This is actually one of my first oil paintings, which is Hearthstone from World of Warcraft, and I really like this one. It's a really nice one. Then there is some acrylic impasto technique practice. I think I may finish this up sometime, so I'll keep this one. This is one of my oil paintings that it's still a little bit sticky because I have no clue how to paint with those. But I think I will keep these just for like reference sake. Oh, yeah. I tried to do Skyrim logo. Some space lily. It's just like it's not focused. Well, I didn't much to see here. This is one of those I really had to keep going. This I tried to paint my WoW character, but I'm not sure will I finish this up. Maybe I will. Hopefully it will be like usable. There's one of my acrylic paint is really old that I haven't finished up. It's like some kind of mechanism. Maybe use this because I have now like the silver metallic paint. And this is actually quite suitable for mechanical engineering. And then two cards. And then another random cloth things that I find. This bag belongs for my oil colors. They have a nice case that goes on that bag. And this goes to trash. And these are... And I use this for my watercolor because I want to use reusable racks. These... I'm not sure what these are in English, but... I think they are nice lace. One of my great-grandmothers was really into like doing these crochet lace things, so I have quite many of these, and I actually really want to keep these. These are really pretty, and I use these for like these on my table, so because I have wooden surface that's makes really loud noise, so I use this as noise reduction because they're nice and thick, and well, I really want to keep this. And actually they do bring me some joy and nostalgic feelings. My ink rack, it's actually bandana that I use because at one point I collected bandanas, and when I stopped collecting them I decided, well, they are really great for like using them as racks, so other one, bandanas racks, this is like for my watercolors too. I use this for wiping paint. And this one of kitchen towel that I used to dry my fountain pens. And these are racks for my oil and watercolors. Oil and acrylic and those kind of things. These are much like cleaner ones and more like disposable things because I don't want to keep oily racks. In my house, I want to throw them out. I'm not sure if it's where is like water soluble oils that has a rust than normal, but these are disposable racks. I have actually, it was old t-shirt that I cut in pieces. So, all of these are keeps because they are useful stuff. So, let's say I have to show these two here. These are my palettes, acrylic palettes. You have my. I'm too lazy to clean these, so I need many. Oh, my watercolor palettes. And one of them is actually plate. But I do enjoy using these. I like using a porcelain palette when doing watercolors, so definitely keeping. Actually, when I was cleaning, I found this like unused palette. This is quite large, but I was thinking I may cut it in here middle. Because this is made for like standing and I'm not sure how this would be held, but not definitely for my hand.